Now, Kai is not normally long-winded, but, and I don't know why we do this. Basically, Matt Iseman, the beloved co-host of American Ninja Warriors, either you squished your mic or your mic died.
Wait, I didn't squish it. Are you calling
He blew it up.
No, my magnetic personality ruined the mic.
Oh, no.
And so, you are a pro. That was impressive. That was so impressive.
We show you every word we have. We make 50 mistakes a day, every day, and they're like, we can't show us changing the mics. The world will blow up. So that was like a 21 day, but we appreciate that.
We were afraid the mountain lion P64 had actually come into the studio and was attacking us.
Oh, my God. Dumbest thing we do. I don't get it. Hi, kids. Nice to
see
you.
Hey.
Another season.
Yes. Another season, but is it a different take?
So this is American Ninja Warrior Ninja versus
Ninja.
Did
you have to say it like that, man?
Yeah.
It's just the only thing I can do. So it's head-to-head action. We'd previously called it Team Ninja Warrior. Right. Now it's on the USA Networks every Thursday night at 9 p.m. We're heading into our third night. You can see it here. It's a double course.
Wow.
Athletes are on it simultaneously. And Akbar. It
Amazing.
Completely changes the dynamic.
I mean, you get a lot of wrestling, you get a lot of elbowing, you get a lot of aggressive play in American Ninja Warrior. And this is different, whereas you typically will see on our flagship, you'll see one person taking on the course. With Ninja versus Ninja, I mean, it's just a lot of pushing and shoving. For me personally,
they're banging
I
bodies.
Like it, especially if you like, I mean, you can see the excitement. It's just nonstop action. If you like contact sport, if you like the physicality, if you like on the edge type of thing, Ninja versus Ninja is where the action is.
Because in my son, watches every version as any kid loves it out of his mind, but it's usually very like precise.
Right.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
Well, that's exactly right, because on American Ninja Warrior, there's no room for error. There's $1 million on the line. One mistake and it's done. Here, you can touch the water. If you go down, you're likely to get another run. We call it nitrous fueled, high octane. We sell the whole thing, but you only need the edge action.
Yeah. Here he goes again.
Yeah.
When he leaves you like a phone message, just in real life. It's like, it's Matt. How are you?
I typically don't check his voice messages. I'll just read. I'll just read because when you do check it, it's just like, it's so intense.
My voicemail, it's Matt Iseman. And my mom is like, you're in your 40s now.
Right. No, it really is that way. Let me give you his phone number. It's 310-6. Oh, okay.
But you know what? We have this big fancy green room, which we also refuse to show you. Our Jets are very excited. Can we bring them? You liked meeting Wing.
Oh, yeah. Oh, Wahoo's yes. Fish Tacos. Are you kidding?
I love Wahoo Tacos. I grew up having that at San Diego State.
Is this the taco
down
at
the beach, they have it in Manhattan Beach.
Toe-to-toe on tacos.
Oh, man, this is great.
There you go.
Is this the 1988 tacos? Is this the 1988?
I think the fish tacos.
I love. You have to have the spicy chai tacos,
it's
too.
It's always fun coming here.
So good.
A, you guys treat us like kings. And B,
I'm gonna let him
usually there is phenomenal food involved.
Right. Okay, good.
And the good news is only one of us had to compete in American Ninja Warrior this year.
Well, I'll tell you something else.
Yeah.
Ninjas eat this too.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Ninjas love Wahoo Tacos.
They're a protein.
Well, you guys munch. Let me show you a clip of now Ninja versus Ninja.
Action.
All the stuff. Observe.
And it's Alexi at the slight early edge. Get it. Arnold, the legendary climber, though, so watch when they get to the tilting ladder. Brian Arnold's got to be considered the favorite here, but the Brazzy bro hanging with him. And this is where that climbing background comes into play. But they are matched neck and neck, and Gomez goes for the dismount. Opens up a lead and just bounds through the floating tiles.
This would be a massive upset.
But here comes Brian Arnold. He's going to try to catch him on the very tricky flying monkey bars.
They are
Is there not a sinister guy necessarily, but is there just some guy in an office with a pad of paper and he's like, how about if we do? And they draw these.
You know who it is? It's the people at home who've come up with some of our best obstacles. Yep. We had an obstacle design challenge, and our most difficult obstacle last year was designed by one of our athletes.
And we have one that was designed by a six-year-old.
A 19-year-old, a 7-year-old, and a 9-year-old have been some of our best designers in crayon.
Kids have no limits. That's
you guys are trying designing one, and that's pretty cool, too, because it gets the fans involved in it. So you're also a part of the process. Right. You get to see how, like, I wonder if we design something like that. But we also have an amazing team, too, with our executive producers and ATS that also designs these. crazy obstacles, which is pretty impressive.
I designed an obstacle, but it involved fish tacos.
Look at this. By the way, while you're still talking and trying to, this is ninja versus ninja right here. I competed and I got my fish tacos done first.
American Ninja Warriors, ninja versus ninja. It's Thursdays at 9 on USA. You guys are welcome back.
Will you just eat your taco?
I'm eating my taco.
Thank you, guys. Always good to see you.
Always the best.